So you confess to all the ways you deceive. Now you feel regret, but that don't mean to me. No, no, so empty what you can say. I should have known better. How could I be so naive? I don't know. So empty what you can say. Take them with you, please. It's too late to make it up to me. I hope that those tears refresh your memory, yeah. Now when you're all alone at night,
Remember Me, featuring Jessie J. That is my special guest in the house right now. Renowned for the killer mixtapes and EPs, Those Who Wait, Songs That Remind Me of You is currently out there now on a free download, Alone Together as well. Believe in the States, that was yes. The man, yes, all of which we shall discuss in detail later. Daily, welcome along to you, brother.
Hello, hello.
Yes,
how you doing?
Good to have you in the studio of myself.
Good to be here. Good
yeah,
be
man,
here.
How you been, man?
Good, busy, you know, working away.
Working really hard.
Yeah.
You don't seem to stop, though.
No, well, you can't really. You can't stop, you know, you get left behind, so you got to keep it moving. And there's always, you know, luckily I'm always, there's always plenty to do, so working towards the album and everything, so.
Yes, indeed, we're going to talk about that. Congratulations on a few things. The single Broken.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is going to be kind of the big official single, which will be launching the album, I guess.
No, well, it's the one before, there'll be another one before the album, or at the same time, you know, but that this is the first kind of solo, proper one.
Okay, yeah. And that's coming out. Let's get the release date in now, nice and early, and
yes.
Then we can keep reiterating it throughout the interview, but I believe it's coming out on the 29th of September.
That's right, 29th.
And, yeah, it's a beautiful record, it's a great tune, we've been on
thanks,
that
man.
Right here on my side,
oh,
so I'm going to be playing
you.
It later on the show. But, yeah, man, I don't know, when the last time I saw you, I DJ'd for you.
Yeah,
the Jazz Cafe.
Yeah, didn't
get to see you though, man.
I know. What was that? That was like.
It was
yeah.
so busy in there.
Yeah.
I mean, where the DJ box is compared to the stage, you
yeah.
can't really get to it. And
yeah,
I didn't
yeah,
really
yeah.
get a chance to come upstairs and,
yeah.
and check you out. But listen, I didn't get a chance to say unbelievable show. I tweeted you, I think, but
yeah,
that was a big show. When was that?
That was a while back now. Well, actually, was it last year? Yeah, well, actually, was it last year? Yeah,
I think
like
it was.
Like early last. Well, like May last year. Yeah, yeah.
You actually announced. That you you just been signed in the States
yeah.
as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that was
it happened around the same time. Yeah, so it's good.
Another momentous occasion.
Yes, yeah.
So all things are happening in abundance for you. This it's full of goodness, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's all going the right way, you know.
That record, remember, maybe just played full of hooks in there, full of, like, you know, Misha Paris beat lines, and, you know, Marlene the Shore sort of hook lines as well. How did that tune come about? Tell us about that record.
That was just like, I'd been writing the album and I felt like I'd kind of got all my serious stuff, emotional stuff out the way, you know. I'd kind of done a lot of that and I was like, I just want to have some fun, you know what I mean? Like, I love Misha Paris and I love Should Have Known Better, which is the song that's taken, the bass line is taken from, originally, like, written by Omar. And so we kind of like, I was like, I like that. And then I just remember me, obviously, it's just such a wicked vocal part. And so I just had some fun, like, is there a way to combine this? So I was in the studio with the producer I was working with at the time, White Nerd, and we just managed to kind of combine them. And then I wrote a song around that with the verses and everything, and that was it, and it was done. And I was like, okay, sounds good, you know, with the sample and everything. And I was like, but I think it just needs a voice, you know, like, for the chorus. And me and Jesse had always, like, I've known her for a while, and we'd always said when the right song came along, we'd do, you know, something. So, yeah, sent it over and she loved it. So
fantastic. It was so born. Jumped on it.
Yeah.
Jumped on it in the video as
Yeah. We literally did it the next day. Well, not the video. We did the recording the next day and then video a few months later in the States. So
amazing. I had Omar on the show. I talked to him about that record.
Really?
And he kind of veered off and went, you know, me and Misha fight about that record all the time.
Yeah, well, that was the thing. Yeah. There was like, you know, even because obviously you have to clear the samples and stuff. And then we were inquiring about it and they hadn't even figured it out between them, really.
Absolutely. It's still, I think it's still ongoing. They kind of have a fight about it, then make up, then it's
mad. I mean, and when would that come out? In like the early 90s?
I think it is early 90s, about 92 or something like that.
It's crazy. It's a long argument.
Exactly. So listen, I mean, is that the sort of music you was listening to back in the day? Like I said, you got the likes of Misha Paris in there, a bit of Marlena Shaw, if you want to sort of Blue Boy as well, kind of use that. What sort of music was you listening to when you was younger, growing up?
Well, when those records were around, I can't say I was like, you know, I wasn't like into them at that, you know, into it at that time. It was just, I was too young, but it was what I was around. You know what I mean? It's the sat, you know, they still have memories for me, you know, and like, I remember certain songs. And so that, you know, they're the ones that kind of, they just have nostalgia. You know, I wasn't exactly a big music collector when I was five, but
no, but how, like, was it your parents that were playing music like that and
you
kind of got into it, or on the radio, what was it?
Yeah, I think a bit of both, radio, and then my mum and dad, you know, generally quite, like, you know, into soulful stuff, you know. So I kind of got hints of that, and Sade and George Michael and, you know, just stuff like that. So I kind of just little gems here and there that stuck out to me. So
so I was gonna say, I mean, what would be a typical sort of Saturday afternoon or Sunday afternoon, your mum and dad are there just chilling, or your mum's cooking and you should put a radio on? Is that the sort of thing that would be playing?
Yeah, I mean, my mum used to listen to a lot of Lighthouse Family.
Oh, really? Okay.
Which, you know, like, they're just, and again, their music just holds nostalgia for me. I'm not going to say that's one of my influences particularly, but, you know, nostalgia is quite a powerful thing, you know, when you're like making music and when you're forming your style or your kind of preference and what you like and stuff. So
ultimately, I think everyone has their influences. If you're music, you do have influences. I mean, who would you say is your most powerful influences musically?
Well, it's no secret, but probably Prince, I think.
Really?
Yeah, because, you know, he's the first artist that I really listened to. I always say, you know, who kind of made me want to be an artist, you know, want to be that person who writes their music and has some control over what they do and artistic, you know, vision for themselves. So, and obviously just the fact that he can play everything and he sings, got the most amazing voice, you know what I mean? Everything, really. He kind of really inspired me in that way. So Prince is probably, if I had to pick someone, you know.
Yeah, listen, I'm with you 100% on that. And if I tell you this, it's something that I've been goading Charlie Brown, producer, here with for a long time. I went to the Monchot Jazz Festival and saw him. He did 3 days back to back.
Today? It's not today.
Yeah, this year. Yeah, literally.
Today, I'm getting all flustered.
couple of months ago. Yeah. 3 days straight, did like 2-hour performances.
What he
on
did?
All 3 nights. Yeah, he did.
Do you know what? I was nearly.
Power Generation,
I really, MBG. Really wanted to go. Like, every time I hear that he's doing, even if it's in frigging, you know, Brazil or something, I still think, should I just book a ticket and go? Because I think, like, I've got a friend who we're really obsessed with Prince, and you know, we kind of like, you know, always trying to find out where he's gigging, and he's never gigs in London. It's like, I feel like there must be some kind of like legal
it's weird.
Battle going on,
well,
or something.
He had that stint, didn't he, when he came over and he did like a whole month.
Yeah, he did that. Yeah,
and that's where he's been ever since.
I saw him twice.
Why are you
then
looking at me, Charlie Brown? Like you've seen him or something?
Well, I've seen him. Well, having said that, though, I did like I saw him twice at the O2 when he did that, and then I saw him. Was it 2 years ago when he came to Hop Farm?
Right.
And did a festival. But, you know, I just really now, I've seen his live show, big show. I want to do the after show. I want to go to the jam.
Exactly.
I mean, where there's 200 people and, like.
He does that all the time. He'll get there about 3-4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
And just jam it out with his band. I mean, probably. And at that point, he doesn't even sing really. He just plays the guitar and just gets into a vibe with Larry Graham and all those guys. Incredible. Yeah. So, Prince, I mean, I'm with you on that, man. Salute. Definitely.
Yeah.
So it's been so long. We haven't spoken for a while. I think the last time, when I was on One Extra, you came on my show. You did some acoustic performances. You did Rainy Days. When I heard Rainy Days, that was the first thing I heard that you did. I don't know what you did before that.
Yeah, you were supporting that.
We supported it. When I heard that, I was like, this kid is going to, he's going to smash it. That was all I needed to hear. I didn't need to hear anything else. Subsequently, you've brought out lots of music since then, but boy. And then you did Maxwell's Pretty Wings.
Yeah.
Another awesome, like, version of that, unbelievable. So you know, as far as I'm concerned, you was always going to be, for me, one of the forerunners of soul music in this country.
Oh.
I've got lots, you know. I can't wait to see what's going to happen with the album and all that.
Well, Rainy Day, actually, funny you should mention it, because that is one song where I was like, it's been around for a while, you know, it's the song that kind of got me signed, got me noticed, and but it never had an official release or anything, you know. And so I've kind of I was working on it, and I was in with The Roots in New York earlier this year.
Wow.
And we just pulled up Rainy Day and sort of redid it.
We flipped it though,
so it's like, because we were trying to recreate it and you just can't, so we just flipped it, and now there's like it's got a new life now, so it's gonna be
is it kind of more sort of rootsy neo style, a bit Philly style beats.
I won't give anything away. No, it's not exactly what you'd expect, but it's interesting. So yeah, so that's so it's gonna be on the album, which I feels like it's nice, because I've got my new songs and I've got my one, you know, the one that really got me noticed is on there, so it's good.
Okay, and what about is Blame the World on there?
Yep, it's on there.
Yeah, dude, I'm gonna play that today.
Yeah,
because you brought that in the States, didn't you?
Yeah.
Why did you bring that in the States, not here?
Well, it wasn't a conscious decision not to bring it out here. It's just that I was releasing Alone Together officially in the States as a single, and then, you know, there was an EP that came along with it, so I wanted to give people a taste of the album for that. But I didn't have a release at the same time here.
Okay.
So, but it'll be on the album, so people will hear it.
Dude, I walked into one of the top boys at Polydor. Again, last year, just went in to have a meeting with him and talk about music and stuff.
Yeah.
Catch up. And he went to me. We were talking about you, gonna be honest. He was talking about like stuff that you got coming through. And he went, you got to listen to this. And he played me Blame the World. And I couldn't believe what I was hearing. The tune is so bad. And I know we've rocked it on the last station that I worked on as well. And we're gonna play it right now. I've got my special guest, Daily, in the place. Now, this is why I'm always kicking up such a fuss about this guy. If you haven't heard it already, this track is unbelievable. It's called Blame the World. My Soul Family, enjoy.
Running Corral.
If somebody told me the truth would have hurt me, I wouldn't place the blame, cause nobody's perfect. But you played a cold game and it left you lonely. Now you've only yourself to blame for the fact that you belong in. Yeah. So guess the game is up now, and I was a fool to love ya. The consequences, look now, all this hate for one another. So this is the last time I tried to make it work. You should think of it as a lesson learned.
Running around.
Records like that you have to take back to the TOP. Brand new, coming from the forthcoming album Days and Nights. Yeah. Daily, Blame the World.
If somebody told me the truth would have hurt me, I wouldn't place the blame, 'cause nobody's perfect. But you played a cold game, and it left you lonely. Now you've only yourself to blame for the fact that you belong in. Yeah, yeah. So guess the game is up now, and I was a fool to love ya. The consequences, look now, all this hate for one another. So this is the last time I tried to make it work. You should think of it as a lesson learned. Hey, betrayed your word. On the time we wasted waiting for a better life. Blame it on the love, love, but don't blame it on me, no, no. Blame it on the people that we just could not be.
My soul family, do you understand what I'm saying now? That tune, that's so big, that record. It's like, is that going to be a single at some point?
Don't know, man. You never know. Never know.
Don't know. I'm having one over that. Sorry, guys. I'm having one over that record. You know what I mean? So that's Blame the World, coming on the forthcoming album, Days and Night. We'll talk about that album very, very soon. So, yeah. Exciting stuff, man. I mean, at the end of the day, how are you feeling about getting the album out there to your fans, the fans that have bought the mixtapes,
yeah,
you know, followed you from day one? How are you feeling about it?
I just can't wait, because, you know, I mean, I really get excited when I put new music out. For a while, you know, I'm kind of bad in some ways, because I wait quite long periods before I put music out, you know, like in between, you know.
Yeah.
And like, even just putting out the Songs That Remind Me of You EP like a couple of months ago, It was like a free thing, and it's just nice to just put it out and see people react to it and start listening to it. And so I know with the album it's like that times 10 or times 100, you know. So like, I just can't wait, because then I can tour and I can, you know, really just take the music to the people, and no holding back, or no, like, you know, this is the first bit, you know. It's just like, this is it. So yeah, can't wait.
I mean, look, when you tour, it's going to be crazy, right? Because, like I said, I saw you performing at Jazz Cafe. You had enough material to sort of do your show.
Yeah.
You know, fully intent on kind of rocking the crowd, and they did. They rocked. So,
and that's one thing I am really happy about. You know, with having, even though I put the mixtape out and it was like supposed to be it was an unofficial free project, but it kind of turned into an album in a way. So, but the fact that I've already got an album's worth of material that people know, you know, and then I can add the new stuff into it. It's nice to be able to just give people, they'll be able to give them both, you know.
Yeah. So. Has it been frustrating keeping it under wraps? Like, you must just want to explode with, this is my new stuff.
A bit, but it all happens in stages, you know what I mean? So I never want to rush anything, obviously.
Of course, of course. I hear that. So listen, do you remember the challenge on One Extra? Do you remember that challenge?
Oh yeah, I think I might remember it, you know.
Now, just to enlighten the My Soul family, right? When I was on my, did the old show on the old station, we had a challenge, and the challenge was this. It was for Daly to flip Madonna's Like a Virgin. And we were like, how is he going to do that? There's just no way he's going to be able to do that. I mean, it's a decent song. I think it's a Nile Rodgers record as well, isn't it? It's produced by Nile Rodgers. Yeah. Like a Virgin is produced by Nile Rodgers, the legendary.
Yeah.
We'll see him over the weekend, by the way.
Okay.
Yeah. I'd get in. So, but still, it's quite commercial, isn't it?
It's
quite,
yeah, right, it's from pop, her. It's pure pop.
Pure pop. So when we played that to you and went, look, Daly, are you going to be able to flip this in your own way? He was like, you know what? I'll give it my best shot. You smashed it.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to lie. We were like, I was on, when I got the email through, I was like, I said to management, what can I do? Like, what can I be like? Should I just say I'm ill? Or like, say like, oh, I've got a sore throat. Like, because I was just thinking, how? You know what I mean? How can you do that? And then, it was just like me and my guitarist Patrick, we were at the studio and we were just like, let's just have a go.
Yeah.
And literally the first take we did is the one that we recorded.
Wow.
And that's the one, well, it's not the one that you played because we redid it for the actual show, yeah. But that recording is what I ended up using on the Those Who Wait mixtape. So yeah, people seem to like it.
Yeah, man. Yeah. And it for me, one of the best cover versions. Do you know what I mean? Because of the way you flipped it. Just
it was a lot of fun, man. Good. We were sort of doing it and looking at each other halfway through like, oh, this actually sounds all right.
Do you know what made me laugh though? The Vince Kidd thing.
Yeah. Yeah, I know.
Did you ever speak to him about that?
No, we haven't really seen each other since that, which is a bit awkward, but I don't know.
He did steal it from you though, didn't he?
I don't know.
Come on,
who
man.
Knows, who knows?
Come on.
I know he knew about it, which is, you know, he knew about it because we'd spoke since I released the mixtape.
Dude, that was a liberty.
It's not, at the end of the day, it's not my song in the first place.
No, totally, but the way you did it was the way you did it. Do you know what I mean? So let's not, you know, be nice about it. So moving on, let's get into the single Broken. So tell us, you know, who's it about, what's about, talk to us about the song.
Well, Broken is, I mean, it's weird because usually most of my songs are written about a specific incident, person, you know, like it's really specific. And every now and again, you know, I get a song that is more like I feel like it's more of an anthem, you know, it's not an anthem, but like a, it's just about that general feeling. So it's a collective thing of all the experiences that I've been through, you know, just the revisiting this. Ooh, that's me, sorry. Revisiting the same emotion, you know what I mean? And that's kind of what Broken's about. So just that, it's kind of like just kind of letting it all out. That's kind of what the kind of moment it was. So, okay. And I wrote it with an amazing writer called Andrea Martin, and Chris Loco produced it and co-wrote it. And
she's prolific. Great.
Yeah, she's done. So she actually co-wrote Blame the World with me as well. So.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, should we play it?
Let's do that.
So this is the brand new single being released 29th of September.
Yes.
Tell them. They need to know the Daly crew, the Daly family. Broken on My Soul. Enjoy this.
This is My Soul.
My Soul.
Not a quitter. But I need to give up this fight for my sanity, my pride. Do I leave? Do I stay and try? Any minute, you will say the words goodbye. Give me love, then change your mind and break all that I am inside.
Running.
That's why I'm
around.
Never gonna love. End up broken. I
end up broken. I end up broken. I end up broken. I end up broken. These are stars. These are the days, and they shine for you.
Brand new single from Daily. Watch out, release. The release date is on the 29th of September. You need to go cop it. It's a couple of weeks' time. Daily live in the My Soul building. We'll have more in conversation with him straight after these.
My Soul.
Back in seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we at My Soul have already put out our iPhone app, which you can get free at the App Store.
You realize what this means?
Now, we have an app for your Android phones too.
Sounds like a lot of fun.
Just go to Google Play.
Oh, awesome!
Making sure you have everything Soul everywhere. This is My Soul.
The last Friday of every month, there's an exciting new night in Shoreditch, London. Universal Soul blends together everything soulful, a unique mix of soul, hip-hop, R&B, classics, deep house, and jazzy grooves. Residents Ronnie Harrell and JM, plus guests on rotation, including Kev Beadle, Shorty Blitz, JP, DJ Kenzie, Phil Asher. Friday, the 27th of September, special guests DJ Soul Provider and Chris from the Soul Play Collective. It's absolutely free for everyone before 11 p.m. and ladies before midnight. Universal Soul is at the Bedroom Bar in Shoreditch, London, the last Friday of every month for a truly soulful experience.
My Soul.
Wednesdays, 9 p.m.
Boom bam and there ain't no scam.
Keith Lawrence.
My Soul.
Now that's the good stuff. 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 Good
stuff. Running around.
Deafening silence. You're almost exactly what I need. A definite maybe. It's sure to entice my curiosity. I can't help but think that this doesn't matter. Trying to separate the facts from all the fiction. We're living in a world of contradictions. And if baby you're the truth, then I'm lying next.
next to you when you're the desert sand. I'll be your water, and you're the perfect plan I never thought of.
I don't wanna do this on my own, and you shouldn't have to be alone.
I would rather be alone together.
Be alone together.
Well, my heart's been racing, chasing after you. Ooh, you're the sweetest dream, my incredible. Ooh, yeah, the stars so bright, your eyes the lightest blue. Can't help but stare
at you.
So soft your lips, the wind blows in my hair. Yeah,
come closer, let me whisper in your ear.
'Cause what will be, every chance you give to me,
you will see. Yeah, yeah. You're the desert sand, don't be your water. And you're the perfect plan I never thought of.
I don't wanna do this on my own, and you shouldn't have to be alone.
I would rather be alone together.
We could be alone together.
I'll always keep you safe in my arms.
I will guarantee that I will never break your heart. Always put you first, 'cause you deserve the world.
I know you,
know me, baby.
I wanna hold you.
I wanna show you.
I wanna take you.
I wanna show you.
Two killer vocalists from the UK, Marsha Ambrosius and Daily. He's actually Daily featuring Marsha. One of the two are in the studio with me live. Daily, talk to me about that. I just said to Daily, right? I just went to him. So it must feel good when you come out of the studio and you've just knocked up a tune like that. And you're like, well, you know, we didn't realise what we'd done at the time.
I know, it's weird. It's obviously, we knew we had a good tune. And like, but you know, when you spend, because we spent quite a long time really kind of finessing it, you know. And so sometimes when you spent a long day working on something, you do lose perspective on it. And I can just, like, literally, as time's gone on, I love that song more every day for some reason, you know. It's just, and seeing, you know, how much people love it as well is just like, is really good. Like, even just last week, someone posted a video, Instagram video from a wedding, and it was two people doing their first dance to that song, to Alone Together, you know, and they're like looking at each, you know, in each other's eyes, singing the words. I'm like, you know, yeah. That's like, it's like a big, you know, it's amazing to me. That's like, yeah, better than any other thing you can achieve from your music, to see that it really gets into people's lives and stuff. So,
well, I guess that's why you make music.
Yeah, exactly.
Absorb it properly.
Yeah.
Well, talk to me about working with Marsha. I mean, what was that like? Was it, you know, because she's like, you know, South London girl, you know, full.
She's from Liverpool. You know that?
Originally, yeah, she's got no Liverpool accent at all. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and unless she speaks on the phone to her mum, then
right,
then it comes out.
Come out.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. She's just amazing. You know, we'd never met before. We'd never even, you know, we didn't know each other. And but I was in New York on a writing trip, and she was around, and we kind of just managed to make it happen. Yeah. And you know, I just didn't know. You never know what to expect when you go into a studio with someone you've never met. You know, it could be a disaster, it could be all right, and it could be amazing. So,
yeah,
you know, but we literally was working with an amazing producer called Kenai Finch, and we just kind of all started off doing our own little thing. So Kenai was kind of working on the beat, and then I was doing my little melodies. Marsha was doing her little bits, and then we started singing bits to each other, and then it just literally everything just fitted together just perfectly.
Yeah.
And you know. I don't know. I think that's why it is. Everything happens so gradually that it takes you a while to realise how you feel about the final result, the whole thing, you know.
That's a mad chemistry on that record. I mean, the harmonies, the way everything is clocked together, just yeah. all click together.
Yeah, I think we all brought our A game that day, and yeah. then we did another song together called Pass It On, which isn't Marsha isn't singing on it, but we wrote it together with Kanai, and that's going to be on the album. And it's again just like I love it, you know. It was a good day.
That's amazing that you've sort of, you know, you hadn't really worked together. You've gone in the studio with like a blank canvas.
Yeah.
I think,
yeah. Yeah.
Just
yeah.
come out with that.
And we just, you know, just worked. So, but the only frustrating thing is we still haven't ever done it live together. You know,
really?
Like, yeah. And it's like I'm just can't wait. Really, it's kind of so overdue. We were meant to do it at Essence Festival this year. I was meant to be doing Essence Festival, but there was some drama, not between me and Marsha, but just between like. Label things
Labels,
and stuff, and I couldn't go in the end. And
politics always get in the way.
Always, yeah, yeah. But but yeah, we were going to do it. It was going to be, you know, going to smash it. But it'll happen.
You've had some incredible moments, haven't you? You've done the record with the Gorillaz, David Albarn.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know.
Yeah, no, I mean,
that was like I love that version.
Yeah.
I play the Harry Love version.
Yeah, yeah,
it's
yeah.
Just
that's
crazy.
Yeah, that's like that was the mixtape version. I love it as well. Yeah. I just think he killed it. Yeah, I've been really fortunate, you know, to do. I've had a lot of different collaborations over the last, you know, 2 or 3 years, you know, leading up to my album, which is nice because I've got to experience different things and see how other people do it. Do you know what I mean? And how they work and how they handle it. So, you know, working with Damon Albarn was one experience, and it was amazing to see how he approaches everything.
How does he approach stuff? I mean, like, is he different to everyone else, obviously?
He's just quite matter-of-fact about it, you know. Like, this was one of the first times I ever wrote with someone, really, you know, because I'd been in Manchester and I came down to London, and then the first thing he said to me when I met him, I walk in and he's like, he's in the middle of playing something, recording something, so I, like, kind of wait for him to finish what he's playing, and then he turns around and he's like, oh, hi, and he's like, okay, first things first, collaborations don't always work, so if you're not feeling it, if I'm not feeling it, let's just say, and no hard feelings. And so that was the first thing he said, and I was like,
okay,
good, I'm glad we got that out in the open, but luckily it did work. So.
Were you a bit nervous when you was meeting him as well?
Yeah, because he was, I just wouldn't have thought he would be the first person to champion what I was doing at that time, you know, but again, he's a real musician, you know, and at the end of the day, when you've got two people who are serious about music and you get, you know, get in a studio, that's all it is, two musicians, you know, so. So yeah, there was that, and then, you know, obviously working with Marsha, as I said, and then doing stuff with Wretch on his first album.
Yeah.
And I've also got a song on Wretch's next album, which, you know, which I really love, you know, and he's like part of the musical family, so
of course.
It's always nice working with him. And
what big collabos have you got on this album coming, Days and Nights? I mean, can you give us a couple of little nuggets?
Well, I guess honestly, you know, I've done so much collaboration. I've kept it pretty much on me for the
really?
Album. Yeah, like I've
what,
got
writing wise.
Yeah, well, and feature wise, you know. So I've got Alone Together and Remember Me. So Jesse and Marsha, which are two big, pretty big names, I think. And then There may be like for a single, I'm trying to get something, a little addition to a song, but for the most part, you know, I just want it to be a body of work that shows me and just, you know, so I don't think there's going to be any massive like collabo surprises, because I've done that now for a couple of years, but you never know. Never know.
And then he'll drop the album and there'll be like everyone on it.
Yeah.
Maxwell will be on it, D'Angelo will be on it.
Yeah.
He'll just kill me.
Like,
my interview just sound really bad. So let's go back. I want to touch back on, like, you know, like Marsha Ambrosius, let's use her as an example. You know, she was from originally Liverpool. I know she spent a lot of time in South London. She met Natalie there when I was with Floetry, and she did her thing. Went to Philly, cracked it out there, felt she needed to do that. You've been signed in America now.
Yeah.
Obviously, you're doing things like, I saw a tweet today saying that, you know, you've done the Today Show with Nelly.
Yeah.
Stuff like that's happening.
Yeah.
Crazy stuff. I mean, I want to talk to you about that, actually.
Yeah.
But, you know, would you feel that you would need to move out to the States to kind of crack it out there, or sort of at least try and break that territory before here, maybe even?
I don't know. The thing is, you know, wherever you are, it's always better to be, well, wherever you release your music, it's always better to be there, because, well, you know, the thing is with Alone Together, that was released in the States and I wasn't there. But amazingly, it was still top five in R&B radio there, and it was like, it was, you know, it became a big record with really
congratulations. That's a signal right there. That's
Yeah. But, you know, so, and that was amazing to just kind of be getting emails to say, oh, it's in, you know, it, see it kind of climbing and happening like that. But, and I did get to do some promo, but not, you know, it's just having a presence is just sometimes the most important thing. So I think what it is, you know, I will spend some time in the States, definitely, especially probably towards the end of this year, because I've got my next single coming out there, which is Not Broken. It's a different song.
Right.
And I want to be there to really just give it everything it needs. So definitely going to spend time there. But again, just splitting time between the two, I think, is the most
sensible. So it's not like you're going to go, you know what, I've had enough of the UK.
No, because, you know, I think one of the main things that, this is what I think anyway, that America likes about me or about kind of British artists in general, is that there's something they can't put the finger on, and it's, you know, it is that Britishness and that kind of thing, that it's not what they can get on their own doorstep. So I think if I move out there, there's always a chance that that might be lessened a bit. So I think I definitely want to always be at 50-50 at least, you know what I mean? So
I mean, paint a picture for us. How are you being received out there? I mean, what is it like? Like you say, you've done the Nelly thing. You know, you've done, you're on his new single, Heaven, is it?
Yeah. So, Heaven,
I mean, how is all that? You're blowing up over there, man.
Well, I don't know. I feel like, you know, America has R&B and soul ingrained in it a lot more, you know, and I think it's a lot more, there's definitely, you can have a career that, if I wanted to, I could just go and say, that's all, I'm just going to do pure R&B and soul and like live in that world and that market and probably, you know, hopefully do all right. Whereas here, you can't do that. You know, I couldn't release Alone Together as a single here because mainstream radio wouldn't play it. So it's just different, you know. It's one, I think they're a bit more accepting in general, but also it's just a bit more, for me, it's a bit more dynamic, you know. I can, the people that I collaborate with and find myself around in the States, you know, like Nelly, or, you know, I was working with Pharrell and The Roots, and, you know, these are all people that I really respect, and, you know, I've wanted to work with for a long time. So it kind of has, you know, has its perks. And
it's got to be frustrating for you, like, knowing that, you know, like you just said, in the UK, radio, mainstream radio, all the radio stations that kind of, you know, say that they're on top of things or hip and cool and everything, look at sort of an Alone Together and don't even consider playing it because it's too cool. It's like, you know,
yeah, I know, specialist. It is annoying, but it's like, one thing I do like about it is it pushes me to never be rest on my laurels, you know, because I can do, no, well, sorry, I shouldn't say that. I can't just make Alone Togethers every day, you know. They are special, so that was a special song and everything, but, you know, it allows me to, it makes me stay on my toes, you know, and never just settle for what people might expect from me. So here, you know, in the UK, you kind of have to just, you know, give it a little edge or do something a little
bit
different.
Do you have to compromise?
Not always compromise. I don't feel like I've compromised, you know, everything that I've done, like, well, just with these two singles anyway, you know, there's both, you know, like, songs that I love, and I spent the time really, basically that's what I spend my time on, making it.
Yeah.
Making it the right mix of, you know, of sounds and just getting the songs right. So, yeah.
Man. Well, look, let me play the record that I first heard you on, which was Rainy Days. Are you cool to go back into?
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, play an absolute, for me, an absolute classic. I look forward to hearing what you've done.
Yeah, it'll be good.
Is it really, really different? I mean, it's obviously lyrically it's the same, right?
Yeah, but it's pretty different, yeah. I couldn't have even imagined it before we did it, but we literally, we just said, right, let's just flip it, and pretty much the first take is the recording, so.
Dude, I can't wait. And the album's not coming until, like, January or something.
I know.
I've got to wait that long, dude.
Oh, you know.
I might have to come round your house, you know. You might have to give me a preview on that one. Right, this is Rainy Days. Is it Rainy Day?
Rainy Day, yeah.
It's Rainy Day, the first record I ever heard Daily do, and this is a little bit special. Check it out. It's My Soul.
It's the thought of you, babe. And I know it takes time, so I'm gonna just try. not to think about why you're not here yet on this rainy day when I need you the most. Need you the most. Yeah, yeah. To feel that you're still close. Like on those rainy days, I used to stay here with you. Oh. Why stand out in the rain when we can try again? Oh, oh, oh. I never understood why we had to end. No, 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 no. Ooh, it just isn't fair. So now that I'm lonely with no one to console me, time goes so slow, but life moves on. I sit and make up distractions, but still I'm dying to ask ya about all the things that I don't understand. Like I know I look fine on the outside, but can't you feel that I'm crying behind closed doors? Sitting in my room, waiting for you on this rainy day. 'Cause I'm drowning in the loss. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm drowning in the loss of you. And no matter what it costs,
no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no. I wanna just follow, follow, follow you till my rainy days are gone. Say you don't miss me, 'cause I miss you on these rainy days, the ones I used to spend with you.
Daily Rainy Day. That was the first record I ever heard from Daily, and I was like, oh my days, what's going on with this? This is crazy. And you know, we had to do some investigation and got you on the show when I was doing it. And here you are now, about to release your album. Well, your album's coming out in January.
Yep.
You're going to bring the single Broken Out 29th of September. It's just rolling for you now, man. You're killing it, kid.
Yeah, it's good. It all feels good.
Yeah, it's working. So you must be balling it a little bit now. Now you moved to London.
I've been in London like from this well, not from the start, but from, I've been in London for about 4.5 years now, like.
When I interviewed you the last time, or the first time I interviewed you, you weren't in London yet. You came down from Manchester. I remember you saying,
but you know what? I might have been in Manchester that day, but I'm pretty sure I was in London by then. Because that's kind of what I kind of just upped and did it. You know what I mean? Even before I got signed or anything, I was like, I just need to be down there. So that's what I did. But yeah, I do go, obviously I go back and forth, so you probably caught me on a day when I was on my way back.
Okay, alright, I'll let you off then. So have you been partying a lot since you've been in London, or
do
you
partying?
Do you hold it down? I mean, what, Come on now, you're signed in the States now. You got your album popping soon.
Yeah, I feel like I've got the balance right now. I used to not be able to party because I just used to mess myself up. You know, just get like next day I've got to sing. I'm like, oh. But now, you know, I know my limits, and I know, you know, I'm not a big like drinker or anything though. So when I go out, it's kind of like I do it all on the one night, and then I just don't do it for about a month.
Seriously, you're coming across as being quite innocent, but I don't believe it. I don't believe it for one moment. And what about shopping wise, do you go out and buy extravagant bits now that you kind of, you know?
I don't know what you think, Ronnie. I'm not
you're doing it right. Listen, come on man, you're guesting on Music with Nelly, you're getting big people on your album, you're fleeing from New York to LA to, come on man.
No, it's good. I mean, I'm just keeping it humble, you know?
Keeping it humble, keeping it nice. Well, listen, I mean, like, have you got any live dates that you want to tell the fans of David about?
Yes, yeah, actually, I've got, in the UK, I've got, this month, we're going to announce them this week, I've got three kind of, special, I'm calling them secret shows, because they're only really, I'm only putting them out to people who are signed up to the mailing list on my website, which is daily.tv.
Okay.
So if you sign up for that, you just literally enter your email, and then it'll go, and then, you know, anyone who's on that list will get the info.
Nice.
And it's just doing Manchester, London, and Birmingham, and they're just going to be like just intimate, like kind of cozy little shows. I've got like going to be me, guitar, like a cello, just really like,
wow,
just really space out the songs, you know, and give like a really beautiful experience.
Is that where you're at your happiest, when you're doing it acoustically?
Not like necessarily, because I just do it a lot because it's a good way to kind of get the essence of the song there and let people really hear what I'm doing. But I love working with my band at the moment, you know, they're wicked, they're just so good. And we've got to a really good place, you know, where we've been, the last few shows we've done, I think really smashed it. So I really like both. I like both, but I do like using the cello because it's just makes it really beautiful.
A great instrument, isn't it?
Mm.
I love those. Cellos and harps. Love harp, a harp.
Yeah, I need to get a harp involved at some point.
Yeah, got to do that. And message to your fans.
Message to my fans. Just always thanks, you know, just thank you. So, you know, for sticking with me, because I know I took the phrase those who wait to the absolute extreme with my music, you know, and kind of, you know, my fans have been very patient, and I've tried, you know, I've given them bits along the way, but I know they're definitely ready for an album. So
I know you've got some people that have made some comments here. Big shout out to Emma Allen, says some voice you've got. Charlene says loved him ever since hearing Like a Virgin on my show.
You see
Victoria Speakman says love him and his version of Climax is simply stunning. Yeah, you did Usher's Climax.
Yeah, that was a jazz cafe.
Yeah, it was big. And Jane Billy says Blame has to be a single. Blame the word.
Yeah,
you we'll see. Dude, it's,
now they're listening,
it's a no-brainer, man. It's a no-brainer.
Yeah.
Get it out there, kid.
Love the support. I appreciate it a lot.
No doubt. And what does the future hold for Daily?
Future, more music, albums, singles, music videos, tours, you know, all that stuff that we like.
Yeah.
Just going to keep making the music and see where I end up.
Well, listen, when the album's out, come back, man. I want you to come back.
Yeah, definitely.
Talk us through it, you know, being out there. Don't be a stranger on this show.
Yeah,
definitely. Make sure you come through.
Good to catch
up. I don't know what to play. Shall I play Don Comatic or shall I play Blame the World again? Should we play... It's your choice. I mean, I've got like... What? I've got your version of Pretty Weird. I've got Like a Virgin. Got, you know, songs that remind me of you.
You can end it on... well, we could play that. That's one of my favourites.
I was thinking about getting it up there, though. You know
okay, yeah, let's play Don Comatic, man. That's the vibe. Yeah, let's do it.
That's me. Listen, Daily, thank you so much, man. Do you want to tell him again? The single Broken comes out when?
Yes, 29th of September. It's on iTunes. You can pre-order it now. We've got some wicked remixes coming out soon as well, so keep your eye out for those. And
who's done remixes?
Who have we got? Who's actually on the... Cahill, got Cahill, Trippy Turtle. Is it Trippy Turtle? Yeah.
Trippy Turtle.
Yeah, we've got some good little vibes on there, so
I love the original.
Yeah.
Me.
Yep, what of Broken?
Yeah.
Well, that's good. And we've also got it's gonna be like a strings and vocal version, so no drum, just like string, beautiful strings and vocal, and so you get like that pureness from that.
And Days and Nights is the album it's gonna be called.
Yeah.
What does that mean? What's the significance of the title for you?
Oh, I don't know if you've got time to go into that. No, it's a title of one of the songs on the album, which is my favourite song. Just a really personal song, and it's one I wrote with Bernard Butler. And it's basically it's just, for me, it's what sums up the album. Like, in terms of sonically, it's very me. I feel like it's very unique to the album. And it's basically, you know, Days and Nights is just a way of saying that this is my life. You know, this is you know, my days and nights over the last couple of years. And, you know, the thing of everything kind of blurring into one when you're really working at it, and, you know, your life is just
rolls into one.
Yeah, so, and that's what the song's about. And yeah, it's kind of simple, but it has, you know, it's quite, means a lot to me, you know. Yeah. What it's about. So
okay, well, good luck with that.
Thank you.
I look forward to that. I hope it lands in January.
Yeah, me too. that's what I'm aiming for.
And best of luck with the single Broken. I know that's going to smash it.
Yeah, thanks
as well. We're going to end on end the interview with Donkomatic, which was a track that you did with Damon Albarn, the Gorillaz.
Yeah.
Basically, this is the Harry Love remix that came on your mixtape.
Yeah. He it was funny because it was like an unofficial remix after, you know, and then I was like, look, this has to be heard. So, you know, just included it on the mixtape, and people loved it, man. And we when we do it live, we do like a nice, it's a nice, good version.
Really?
Live, yeah.
Big shout out to my boy Harry Love as well. Bad boy DJ.
Yeah.
Crazy. Daily, nice one, brother.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming through. Let's get into this.
Download me. Make up for the time you wasted. Come slowly and claim back the boy you left behind. Close the white door, unplug the brain from the game. Cause it's time to wipe it out to the stars, get on the face. The song is not the same when we're all played out, all played out. Even if it's only to escape, just download now before somebody steals your place. Close the white door, unplug the brain from the game. Cause it's time to wipe out to the stars, get on the fame. And the conversation's over, we're all playing. For the time you waste, come slowly. Claim back the boy you left behind, and close the white door, unplug the brain from the game. It's